I'm here today looking at my old thermostat, which is kind of big. It was put in for an air conditioner. And I just got a new Nest thermostat, the simple one, the cheaper one. And in fact, our electric utility gave it to us for just 10 bucks and change. Comes with two batteries, in fact, in it that are rechargeable, and they get charged off the 24 volts that all thermostats have supplied to them. It comes with a little plate that gets installed with two screws that it comes with, and there's also a bubble level to make sure that you have it leveled. The first thing I'm going to do is try to remove my thermostat from its location. This one, yeah. So now I've got it at least open. So there's three screws holding this to the wall and a very small hole where the wires are. And these are the special wiring diagrams for the thermostat. And there's two sets of wires. And if you look closely, you will see that they are labeled OW/W2, Y/W2. And then there's things like S1, S2, and so forth. And in this one, it's very important. We are going to take a picture with our phone of the exact wiring diagram here, just to be sure.
So we don't forget where the wires came from.
The other thing that's really important is that the Nest comes with these labels. So you can actually figure out which label to put onto which wire on your thermostat. That'll help with your connections. So for example, my yellow wire here, this one actually says Y1 on it. So I would put the Y1 label on it.
I've got the green wire that goes to the G pin and the red wire that goes to the R pin.
But I've got this blue wire in here. And what do I do with that blue wire here? I'm not sure because it's labeled Y2 or W2. There's one star for W2 here. You can only use one star sticker here on the Nest thermostat because when you look at the Nest here, what you can see is it has a GR and a star here, and then it's got your Y, C, and W. So I have to figure out where these wires go. This is my next task. And if you look at this, this is sort of interesting. So this has an S1, S2, a dehumidifier, and a black one, which is called C. So this would be my common wire, C, right here. So I have my C tag, so I know where that goes. That goes right here.
So we know how to specify the wire to pin mapping for the C pin, the G pin, the R pin, and the Y pin. Here you can see the blue wire, the red wire, the green wire, the yellow wire, and the black.
Black goes to C, which is common, and I can see the C. The C goes right here. But interestingly, these two wires, they say S1 and S2 here. And you can see it on the circuit diagram.
Notice that
we have
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 wires. Whereas we only have 6 pins in the Nest. So now I have to tag all my wires before I disconnect them, which I've done. I put the R tag on the red wire. I put the Y1 tag on the yellow wire. I put the G tag on the green wire. I put the C tag on the black wire. And I put the W2 star tag on the orange wire. And the W1 star tag goes to the blue wire. Okay, now I can disconnect the thermostat and I just have all my labeled wires sticking out of the wall. I still have to solve the problem of mapping the 8 wires to the 6 pins.
So I discovered that 2 of those wires are just sensors that are not being used. That's my S1 and my S2. So I'm going to connect those 2 wires, which I've done already, and then wire nut them together. My circuit breaker for the thermostat has already been turned off, by the way, so I have no worries about sticking 2 wires together. I'll be able to push both of these into the hole. Okay, so now we have a lot less to work with. Hopefully we'll be able to get those wires out if we ever need them again. And now we've got everything labeled, and let's see what we can do.
Since the holes from the previous thermostat don't match those of the Nest, I'm going to use some wall anchors. And I'm going to install the wall anchors in such a way that I can screw the Nest to the wall. So I'm going to mark the holes with a pencil, and then I'm going to use an awl to dig the holes into the wall, which is not that difficult to do. Once I have the holes in the wall, I will hammer in the wall anchors so that I can screw the Nest to the wall through the wall anchors. Uh-oh, the Nest will not cover up all the holes from the previous thermostat. Lucky for us, we have a plate that will fit behind the Nest and also cover up the holes. After we check the bubble level, we can fully screw it in before we connect the wires to the Nest pins. Remember the mapping. The green wire goes to the G pin. The red wire goes to the R pin. The yellow wire goes to the Y pin. And the black wire goes to the C or common pin. I need to mention something about common wires for this particular model of Nest thermostat, which is the cheaper model. You actually cannot use it if you don't have a common wire, unless you have something that will fake that common wire connection so that you can make sure that the batteries get charged. We had two more wires to connect according to our mapping, and just to note, we used needle nose pliers to twist the ends of the stranded wires to get them tightly into the connectors. Once we have all the wires in, we can push the excess into the wall so that we can apply the cover of the Nest. This assumes, of course, you've already installed the batteries into the Nest. At this point, you can turn on the circuit breaker for the equipment that this Nest is controlling. And then, as it says, you go to the home app on your phone in order to finish the setup. This was a little confusing to me when I got to the home app because it starts with heating and this Nest is only to be controlling my air conditioning. So I skipped that part and I went straight to cooling.
Choose which mode your thermostat is in. So I'm going to select cooling. Heating is the default.
Now I click next in the home app and I'm asked to connect my Wi-Fi to the Nest. And I do that through the home app. Once I do that, updates are being downloaded into the new Nest. Once you have updated the Nest, you can set up a schedule if you'd like through the home app. But when the Nest is running, you can do what you like. You can just keep it or make the schedule.
Well, here's a few nice features. So you can swipe up and down and change the set temperature. You can tap to make a selection or bring up a menu. You actually tap here. Actually tap on the side and you bring up a menu. And so that menu, we have the weather forecast that it's 33 degrees, so there's possible snow. It gives you the time and the indoor temperature and the humidity, and that's it.
So I just set my schedule so that it hits 90 degrees since it's winter time and I don't want my air conditioning to come on. I hope you enjoyed this video on how to set up the Nest thermostat. It's the simplest thermostat, but you do need a ground or common wire in your wiring in your wall. That's about it. Please subscribe to CB99 videos and give us a super thanks if you like.